But why, some say, the moon? Why choose this as our goal? And they may well ask, why climb the highest mountain? Why, 35 years ago, fly the Atlantic? Why does Rice play Texas? We choose to go to the moon. We choose to go to the moon. We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other things, not because they are easy, but because they are hard.
Coming, what a crowd! Holy cow, look at all these people, my gosh! This is a beautiful crowd! I hope no one here has epilepsy, because I've got an extremely bright future, so... what to do with this hand? Thank you so much for coming along! This is unbelievable! Friday night, we're doing it! We're out here, Friday, bloody night! This is good. Thank you so much for coming down to the prestigious basement of the Victoria Hotel. They put all the best acts down in the Fritzel room. This is good. Great to be here. Thank you. So you seem like a hot crowd. Sometimes, I come out, there's no vibe, you know? And I'm like, why is there no vibe? I think it's because this is a conference room, you know what I mean? The second you walk in here, you feel like I'm about to learn what is and what is not appropriate to do in the workplace. Not appropriate to go up behind someone, put your hands in front of their eyes and say, guess who just clogged the toilet? But what a crowd. Holy cow, I'm off to an unbelievable start, wouldn't we say? No, thank you so much for coming. This is a nice sized crowd for me, I've got to say. I'm not great at advertising myself. It's not one of my strong suits. I wish I was as good as some of those real estate agents. Have you seen them? Unbelievable, these guys. I saw one in Sydney, there's this guy, his big head is on the back of a bus. His whole head on a bus. And they just give their numbers out as well. Have you seen that? Just handing their numbers out. Crazy. Saw this guy, big head on the back of a bus, his number underneath. Then under that, it said, a real estate agent you can trust. And I did trust him. I made him my emergency contact. My girlfriend's out, Jamal is in. So. Thank you so much. God, what a hot start. We're having a great night so far. Anyone's got an up and go, feel free to pull it out now. This is the up and go part of the show.
God damn.
Are you all mostly from Melbourne? Melbourne peeps here?
Yeah.
Hell yeah, I'm from Sydney, but let me tell you, this is a gorgeous city, unbelievable. Panda to the crowd. This is the best city I've ever seen, hottest people, best people. And no, everyone very fashionable down here in Melbourne. I'm seeing a lot of mullets, and I like it. But I feel like the mullet used to mean one thing. If I saw a fella with a mullet, I would know he would be the type of person that would say, I don't care what gay people do, as long as they don't do it in front of me. Don't you reckon? So, but now everyone's got a mullet, you know? I saw a kid at the airport, 10-year-old kid, skinny, had glasses, but a big long mullet, had a Yu-Gi-Oh backpack on. I don't even know what he thought about gay people, you know? to ask him. His dad pulled me away from him. I didn't get to hear. Just a curious guy. Just a curious stranger. I know, good stuff. And God, Friday night, big night. Everyone's going to be partying, I bet. Drinking a few Tia Marias. Nothing wrong with that. A few Sambucas. No worries. I saw last Friday, as I left my venue, there were a couple, you know, fellas out, a pack of fellas out on a big Friday night, you know, drunk, testosterone-filled, strong. They looked a lot like me. And they were walking up the street, and then one of them started saying to the other one, they were saying, fucking do it! Fucking do it, you pussy! Fucking do it! I was like, oh boy, what's going to happen here? Then one of them started running up the street a little bit, then launched into one of the most beautiful, majestic, like, triple cartwheel, backflip, double loop-de-loop things, and, like, landed it. I'm like, that was low down on the list of what I thought was going to happen. I don't know what I just witnessed here. The most toxic group of male gymnasts I've ever seen. This is disgusting stuff. It's, just got security ready to go just if I need them, but no, God, you seem hot as hell. No, this is good. I don't know if anyone here feels like they have a sixth sense for anything, but I feel like I have a bit of a sixth sense for something, and sorry to be so crass so early in the show, but I can always tell when a fella is circumcised or uncircumcised when I see their penis. When I see the penis, I know for sure, 100%. But I'll tell you a bit about me. I'm one of these Jews you hear about. You meet all these guys, and... I'm reading a lot of news about the Jews. It doesn't all seem good for the Jews lately. You know, I'm reading some articles. Seems like there's a bit of anti-Semitism out there. And I just think if this anti-Semitism, if it continues or if it gets even worse, you know, I just think that's going to lead to a lot more TV opportunities for me. So I say, let's keep it up. You know what I mean? Yeah. You know, sometimes you see in the news, someone's drawn a swastika somewhere. Who do you think's doing it? It's me, okay? Get me on Lego Masters. But, God, what am I proud? And thank you so much for coming. I'm sure a lot of you have no idea who I am, but maybe you saw some of my 5-star reviews. I'm not sure if you saw any of those. If you haven't, I'll show you a few of my 5-star reviews. So this was one of them. I get 5 stars to M9 Laser Skirmish. Came on my own. People thought it was ballsy and cool. So that was... I get 5 stars to Cabantra and Chocolate Squares for Worms. I know they're for worms, but for me, they're a little cheap meal. Anyone else? Big Friday night, I'm going to go home, shovel back a couple of bloody Cabantra. Anyway. I don't have worms, but I'll say this. Even if I did have worms, I wouldn't get rid of them. Look how goddamn cute they are. I don't want to kill these guys. Yeah, I'm having a great little time. It's in my asshole. No, stand-up's been going unbelievable for me, and I'm sure maybe some of you saw something I did last year. It was pretty huge. I'd be surprised if you didn't see it. I was the first comedian in the world to record a stand-up special from the reverse camera of a car. Did anyone see that? Nobody caught that. Oh, I thought it was pretty big. This is a little clip of it.
What's up, guys? I'm bringing back old school comedy.
Did you say bring it back?
No, bring it back.
Best part of the show, so it's downhill from here. Oh my God, this crowd is too nice. Oh my God. But yeah, I've got a big year coming up. Later this year, I'm going to be riding a unicycle all around Australia to raise awareness for bullying. I'm trying to bring bullying back, so it's going to be great. But stand-up-wise, things have been good. Money-wise, a little bit tight for me. I don't have a lot of cashish at the moment, so I've been trying to do a few extra things to make a bit of extra money. I've been doing some medical testing, so that's been good. So I don't know if anyone's done that. You get a few vaccines, ointments, tablets. It's awesome. So it's been great. No side effects so far.
So far.
Yeah. Sorry, did someone say something? If you did say something, you're going to have to speak into my good ear. So, You don't like that joke? I can't hear you! Double ear gag. Classic double ear gag. I tell you what, this is good stuff. I've already started working on my show for next year, though. Always got to be grinding, hustling, you know what I mean? And I'm not going to be doing a comedy show next year. I'm going to be writing a musical, so that's very exciting. It's going to be, thank you, it's going to be 127 hours of the musical. So I think that movie is ripe for a musical. Yeah, I'm surprised no one's done it yet. I'm going to be playing, you know, that one where James Franco goes into the dead, gets his arm stuck under a rock. So I'm going to be playing the role of James Franco, and then the rock is going to be played by, you probably guessed it, Paul Giamatti. So that's a little passion project for me, but this is good. Great to be back in Melbourne. I did a show here last year. I had a lady come up to me after the show, and she was like, "Are you on the spectrum?" I was like, "I feel like at least one of us is." You know what I mean? Like, I might be. But also, I feel like going up to a stranger and saying you're on the spectrum, pretty on the spectrum thing to do, if you ask me. You know what I mean? Game recognizes game, yeah? You know? Or like two bus drivers nodding at each other. You know? I will say this, though. I don't know if I am on the spectrum. I'm not great at making eye contact, though. But there are some benefits to being bad at making eye contact. I find a lot of money on the ground. So it's good always looking at the floor. But I don't think I am on the spectrum, but I just reckon I'm a bit of an awkward fella, you know? And I thought I'd get less awkward as I got older, and I haven't. But I have gotten more used to it, you know what I mean? So now I'll be speaking to someone, the conversation will come to a grinding halt after 5 seconds. There'll be a long 30-second silence, you know? They're getting uncomfortable, they're squirming, I feel fine. I'm like, you're in my house now, man. I've done my 10,000 hours of being a fucking weirdo, you gotta catch up. I used to try to say something, you know, there'd be a silence in my brain, like, just say something, you know, to feel the silence, but it would never be good. I'd just say something like, hey, you ever watch porn on a smart fridge? It's an interesting way to do it, I gotta say. Anyway, enough fart-assing around. Let me tell you what this gosh darn show is about. First, let me set the scene with a little bit of music. Here we go. Oh, that's nice. Anyone know what movie this is from? Any guesses? No guesses? Nobody knows? All right, it was Herbie Fully Loaded. it was Interstellar. But I just remembered I have to stop playing because we got an email before the festival started. They said if you use any like music in your show, they can charge you for it through like licensing things and stuff like that. So I don't want to have to pay for it. But I did make my own version of that song, which I think is pretty similar. Bim boom 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 bim boom. Alright, this is what the show is actually about. So this happened, I don't know if you guys heard about this, this happened in 1977. NASA, they shot these two golden records, they shot them into space, and on the discs were sounds and images of what life was like on Earth, and it was for possibly aliens or intelligent life that they would, if they could find the disc, and if they happen to have a record player, because they are actually on records, then they could see what's on the disc, and then they'd want to come here to Earth, you know, and hang out. Get a cafe latte. You know, we can share streaming platform passwords, you know? We give them binge, they give us happy rap, you know? But this was a long time ago, as I said, 1977. A lot of things have changed since then. I think the disc is outdated now, you know? I think it needs an update. And who better to update it than me? Thank you. I've got my finger on the pulse. I also had my finger on the pulse of a millennial who I hit off his e-scooter on the way here, but he's going to be fine. Don't worry about him. So that's what this show is about, pretty much. I'm going to be showing you what's on this disc, and then I'm going to be saying what I think should be on the disc now for 2023. So let's go through a few of the things that are on this crazy old disc. So I'll show you a few of the images. So this is boring. Maths. Who gives a fuck? More maths. Why would an alien care about this? Oh, I'm glad we know about 333,000 E. More planets, boring. Oop, selfie. That's a good one. Oh, this one's a bit more fun. Sperm entering an egg. You guys like this? I'm actually pretty vanilla. This is what I look up on Pornhub. I just want to see the sperm entering the egg. This one's an interesting one. He's circumcised, by the way. I don't know if anyone sees anything they think is kind of interesting about. I thought it was kind of interesting. We're letting all the aliens know that we're all 160 centimetres. It's pretty little. What if some of the aliens are superficial, some of the ladies on Earth? Don't even talk to us if you're under 6 foot. These aliens might say, not that I would know about that. But I actually read about this surgery that short fellas can get. I don't know if you've heard about it. There's this surgery that you can get where they break all the bones in your legs. They break all the bones and then they extend them a little bit and then you get a little bit taller. Yeah, it's $250,000. Crazy. And it's not like you go from like 5'4" to 6'10". That'd be cool. Long, skinny legs. Tiny torso. Look like an umpire's chair walking around, you know? That'd be fun. Oh, you get from like 5'4" to 5'7". What's the point of that? You could still pick up a few turtlenecks at Oshkosh Bagosh at that height. I wouldn't get that surgery. I wouldn't make my legs really long. I'd actually break my arms, make my arms really long. Imagine that. Is anyone even imagining it? You've got to imagine it. Imagine you're walking around the city all day, oh, your legs are all tied, you know, just put your arm out, it's on the ground. Turn yourself into an easel, that's kind of nice. I could fall asleep in this position. Imagine how good it'd be at the sushi train. You know what I mean? Someone's eyeing off the salmon nigiri, you're like, oh, guess what, I made seats away, you're getting nowhere near me, mate. That's fine. That'd be good. What else is on this crazy disc? Got a lady eating grapes in the supermarket. I like this one. This is more about, like, you know, letting the aliens know about the minutiae of life. You know what I mean? Like, you know, if you come to a supermarket, you can eat a couple grapes. Okay? It's not a big deal. All right? I think there should be more stuff like this on the disc. You know, just weird little things about life, you know? Like the fact that the only time you hear about broad daylight is when someone's getting stabbed in it. You know, that nothing good is happening in broad daylight. They should warn us about that in the weather report. Let us know how broad the daylight's going to be. Maybe I'll leave the house with my nunchucks, you know what I mean? Get the protection. I've never done that act out before, but I'm pretty happy with it. I'm going to keep that act out. The coolest way to protect yourself. Anyway, but another weird thing about life that happens sometimes, you ever like at a restaurant and you ask to use their bathroom and they're like, sorry, you gotta walk through the kitchen to get to the bathroom. Ugh, I hate that. I never want to see the people making my food. It's never the cleanest looking fella I've ever seen in my life. It's always the type of guy, he's got like a tattoo of a hairnet, but no hairnet, you know, that type of guy. Happened to me recently, I had to walk through the kitchen to get to the bathroom. There was a guy working there and he was focused. He didn't turn around. So I walked behind him and he just thought I worked there as well. He's like, can you put those fries on over there? And because I'm not very assertive, I was like, yeah, I'll put the fries on. And, anyway, I've been working there 3 years now. So come down to grill, get us in there. Anyway, this last image on the disc, this is like a weird, it's like one of the weirder images. It's supposed to show the aliens what eating, drinking, and licking looks like on Earth. But who does any of those things like this? Who eats one side of the sandwich, flips it over, and eats the other side? This guy should be in jail. This slob, just sloshing water all over. Disgusting. I had a lady come up to me one time. She saw this. She said she had a visceral reaction to it. After the show, she came up to me. She said she almost walked out. Imagine that. I get a walkout because of this photo. And not because of the 30-minute chunk on trans people I have coming up later in the show. Cheeky. Cheeky guy. Anyway. So those are a few things I wanted to show you on the disc. Before I tell you what I'm going to put on my disc, I want to tell you a little bit about space, because it is one of my interests, and I don't have many interests. This is space, comedy, and obviously, jujitsu. Love jujitsu. Cannot stop doing jujitsu. I love it because I don't mind getting choked a little bit. So it's good if you don't mind getting choked out by a 40-year-old accountant with a sweat gland issue, you know? It's good. He's got his arm around my neck. He's going, tap out, tap out. I'm like, why would I? I'm having the time of my life right now. It's awesome. I'm actually a black belt in jujitsu. Which is weird because that's what I used to use, you know, little black belts and oh my God, it's just a gag. And it's just a gag. But I do feel a little bit kooky having a show about aliens, you know, it's a bit kooky, a bit weird talking about aliens. I feel like one of those guys who wears a tinfoil hat. And I am going to wear a tinfoil hat. But I've classed it up a little bit. I'll show you my one. Pretty good, tinfoil fedora, am I right? Best of both worlds. Now the government can't hear my thoughts, and I look like one of those guys that slides into a lady's DM saying, you deserve the world. But no, I'm into space. I'm not that into aliens, I gotta say. I like space. Not that into aliens, you know. So if you had maybe read the event description of the show, you saw it's about aliens and you want to corner me after the show and be like, well, did you see that one event, that one UFO sighting in Montana in 1972? Maybe you can come back to my place. I've got footage of it. We can watch it, and I've got a few warm Dr. Peppers, and you can drink those. I've got a number of lizards, obviously, that you can look at. And remember you had Nickelodeon used to slime people with all that slime? I bought all the slime. So we can hang out in the slime. So, yeah, I don't want to do that. But not to judge. Although sometimes it is fun to judge. That's why I like watching that show, Hoarders, you know? Just watch it, I'm like, I'm doing better than these guys. Yeah, I don't have a bathtub full of nail clippings at my place. I'm not using my old foreskin as a bottle opener, yeah. Not anymore after that response, I'll throw it out. But I was watching Hoarders recently and I was feeling better about my life, but then halfway through an episode it hit me, I was watching it and I was like, shit, this guy owns this place. You know what I mean? I don't own a house. This guy's doing way better than me. Had the opposite effect. It's like watching 16 and Pregnant to feel better about your life, but it just reminds you that you're 36 and a virgin. Yeah, that's what you're right. I don't even have the privilege of being a hoarder. I gotta do a rental inspection every 12 months, yeah? Got some 17-year-old real estate agent snooping around my house, touching all my things, you know? He's like, what's that bottle opener? None of your business, okay? Put it down. It's a family heirloom. But now I am into space and stuff, and I've been reading about it. I read it's very big, so you guys probably didn't know that. But yeah, it's huge, it's enormous. And because they're always trying to like give you analogies, like to try and help you understand how big space is. I never really understand, I don't think I understand analogies at all. It reminds me of when I was in school one time, and remember when you're in school and like they'd have people come talk to you at assemblies, and there'd never be any sort of rhyme or reason to the person they had coming to speak to you, you know? They'd be like, this week we got a guy coming to speak to you, he was in a war, he lost a leg, he's gonna speak to you about that. And next week we got a guy, and he just owns a lot of Furbies, and he's gonna speak to you about that, yeah? Pretty much anyone who has free time during the day is gonna come speak to you, yeah? We had a blind lady come speak to us one time, she was telling us what it was like to be blind, and then at the end she asked if anyone had any questions. There was a kid next to me, you know, we were probably like 10 years old, and he put his hand up, and he was like, so what do you see if you're blind? Is it all black? And you could tell some of the teachers were like, Billy, I don't think we should be asking that question. But is it all black? Yeah. And she sort of gave this analogy where she said to the kid, she was like, well, what do you see out of your elbow? And he was like, I don't see anything out of my elbow. She was like, well, that's what I see. I don't see anything. And you could tell everyone in the room was sort of like, right. Is it all black? Can you just say it's all black, please? I don't really understand that analogy. Wow, what a long laugh. Security actors got a really long laugh. Really long. I'm going to show you a few discoveries they've made in space news recently. They discovered recently that black holes actually make a noise. It's very creepy. I don't know if anyone saw this, but a couple of people saw it. It's good. This is the sound that black holes make. Very creepy. Here we go. live in a share house. I don't live with other people, I just really like share. Sorry, I know it's weird that my voice was in the black hole, but NASA actually sent me an email and they said, all jokes that I do at open mics that bomb and I never do them again, they get sucked into the black hole as well. That's why my voice was in there. I'll play a little bit more.
So this is my impression of Clint Eastwood, and he's open to exploring his sexuality. Okay.
Go ahead. Make me gay.
I think that one's got legs, so I'm going to bring that one back. I'll show you another character I've been working on. This character's been great for me lately. This character, he's a guy, he's on trial for murder. He's been questioned by a lawyer. But for some reason, he doesn't have a glass of water in front of him. He's got a can of Coke. Sounds pretty funny already to me. So he's on trial for murder, being questioned by a lawyer, doesn't have a glass of water, he's got a can of Coke. Sorry, just one second. I did not kill my wife. That's it. Usually this does well for about two people in the audience, so that's about right. Two people really love it. And I'm sorry to whoever has to use this microphone after me. This was another thing that I found out last year. I was in Brisbane. I went to the Brisbane Planetarium, and I saw that there are two asteroids circling around Earth, and I swear to God this is true. They are called Anne Frank. Isn't that crazy? I always show this expecting big laughs, and everyone's always very upset. I don't know. I didn't name it Anne Frank. It wasn't my idea. Personally, I don't even think it looks like her. You know what I mean? I don't... Anyway. Let me cleanse the palate, read you a little joke. This is not my joke, by the way. Found this online. Thought it was pretty funny. Okay, here we go. A man comes home at night and notices that another man shared the bed with his wife that evening. He searches the whole house and finally also looks in the bedroom closet. There is a totally naked man in there. And when that one man asked what the other was doing in there, the man in the closet answered, "Would you believe I'm waiting for the tram?" Nobody liked it. Well, I didn't even write it, so I don't give a shit. I thought it was pretty funny, though. Well, I'm going to tell you who wrote it now, and you're not going to believe me, but it is true. Anne Frank wrote that joke. I swear to God, you think I'm making it up? But they found this out recently. There are a few pages in the back of her diary that she covered up because she was embarrassed. She wrote all these sexual-based jokes. I'm not fooling around. She wrote that joke. Would Amanda Jackson or Jen look at Mezzafiore lie to you? And I thought if you didn't laugh at it, I think that's very rude. Anne Frank had a hard life, and you didn't laugh at it. I don't even think they should name an asteroid after. I think she should be on a comedy club lineup. Don't you reckon? I think she's got potential. And again, maybe some of you are offended by this. You think she should be the headliner. But I don't think she's ready to headline. All right, moving right along. This was another thing they discovered recently. This is on Mars, and they discovered it's just like this perfect-looking doorway on Mars. And they're just like, well, they don't know what it is, why there's just like a perfect-looking doorway on Mars. But I think I know what it is, or at least I think I know who's up there. Kramer! How'd he get up there? Oh, brother. Man, I wouldn't go to Mars. I looked it up. Apparently it takes 7 months to go to Mars. 7 months? Imagine that. Imagine a weekend, you're like, I forgot one of my charges. Shit. Yay. But I don't even like going on like a 2-hour drive. Even that is too long for me. And my car is so annoying. Because you know how like when you don't put your seatbelt on in your car beeps, you know? It's like, put your seatbelt on. Not that though. It's not my voice. It's a beeping sound. Although I did actually audition to beat the sound. I went in the booth, I was like, put your seatbelt on, come on! And I'm so... Put on! They went in a different direction. But yeah, and don't get me wrong, I love to put my seatbelt on. That's one of my favorite things to do. The thing that annoys me is sometimes I'll put like a bag next to me, on the seat next to me, and it beeps. Thinks there's a person next to me. Right? People love this bit. But it's not. It's a bag. And it's not even a big bag. Like, the bag wouldn't be more than 2.5 kilos. It thinks it's like a baby or something, you know? And it annoyed me so much, I looked up, what's the average weight of a newborn baby? And apparently it's 4 kilos to 4.5 kilos. So it couldn't even be a newborn baby, you know what I mean? It would have to be a premature baby, you know? I'm not trying to be crazy, I mean, but that's what my car thinks I've done. It thinks I've gone to the premature baby section of the hospital. I've said, I'll take your freshest one. I put a shotgun next to me. And then my car's like, put a goddamn seatbelt on that premature baby. You out of your mind? And let me tell you, I haven't done that, okay? Not in a long time. But my car annoys me in other ways as well. Like, you know, sometimes you lean forward too quick, your seatbelt yanks your back, thinks you've been in a car accident. I'm like, again, car, I haven't been in a car accident, okay? I dropped a mint down the side of my chair, trying to reach forward to get the mint so I can freshen my breath, so I can sweet talk the nurses at the premature baby section. Still want those babies. My washing machine annoys me as well, because, like, I'm sure a lot of people have a washing machine like this. If I press start on my washing machine, it locks and you can't get in there till the cycle is done. So annoying. Do you know the amount of times I've been like, oh, I just dropped one sock, can I please put a sock in there? It's like, nah, you can't. I'm like, oh, I accidentally trapped my son in there. Can I get him out? No, you can't. Gotta wait 1 hour and 10 minutes. Hold your breath, Philippe. My son's name is Philippe. It's a crazy system. If someone robbed my apartment, the safest thing in my apartment would be the clothes and the washing machine. Isn't that crazy? I have to say to my girlfriend, good news and bad news. Bad news, they stole all your jewelry. Good news, my undies with the permanent skin marks are fine. So she's very happy to hear. But in other space news, Bezos, Muskie, Branson, they're all doing commercial flights to space there. I wouldn't do that. I'm not much of a risk taker. I sort of feel like I'm like an old man in a young man's body. And I can't wait to get old. I can't wait to get to the age where I can start calling people son. I've always wanted to do that. I've started doing it now just to see if I can get away with it, you know? I'm 30, but I said to my 20-year-old barista today, he gave me my coffee. I was like, thank you, son. He was like, what? I was like, nothing. Just trying something. Yeah. But it's not all good getting older. The older you get, the less chance someone's going to sign your cast. Yeah, at least when you're young, you break your arm. Everyone's like, oh, sign your cast. That's a bit fun. Yeah. But as you get older, the injuries, the ailments, they get a bit more upsetting, you know? Can't really walk around your office and be like, anyone want to sign the gauze on my neck? Oh, I had a basal cell carcinoma removed this morning. Don't press too hard, the stitches are coming loose. Just, anyone want to put a post-it note on my colostomy bag, say something nice to me? Yeah. But no, look, it's not all good getting older. We actually had to put a railing up in my grandma's bathroom recently so she could do more skateboard tricks in there. Brother, but no, I've never really felt young. I've got to say, I was talking to one of my friends recently. He was telling me about a time he was in his early 20s. He was in Europe. He climbed this bridge, did a backflip off the bridge. It was a 20-meter jump into water. And I was like, weren't you scared? And he was like, you know, when you're that age, you just feel invincible. I was like, I'll stop you right there. I've never felt invincible for 1 second in my entire life. I was 18. I had a harness on in the shower in case I slipped. I swear to God. I did. My mum was on the other side belaying me. She had the snake, you know what I mean? I'm not going free solo in the shower, out of your mind. I'll tell you what I was getting up to in my early 20s. I remember it was a Friday night. I was with my 3 friends. We didn't know what to do that night. So we Googled, what do you do for fun on a Friday night? And we got a result. And it said, if you have 4 people, there is a way where you can turn your bodies into a table. Has anyone been a table here before? Losers! You guys gotta be a table sometime. I don't even know how we did it. There's a way you're all like leaning backwards like this and you're like crisscrossing over each other's bodies, and we were naked, but you don't have to be. And that was our big Friday night, just walking around my friend's house as a table like this, you know. Some people are doing cocaine off a table. We were the table, you know. It's crazy. And now I've got a girlfriend, which is nice, and sometimes it's a laugh. I could have a girlfriend. No, I do, I swear to God! Don't make me get the walkie-talkie. But I reckon I do have a girlfriend, and sometimes at night she'll embrace me. It's my favourite part. And she'll say, I've never felt closer to anyone else in my entire life. Thank you. That's nice. And I say, me neither. And obviously I'm lying. I'm thinking about being a table with my friends again. Take you back to the table days. But no, I am excited to get older. I don't want to look old if I could avoid that. That would be nice. So I try to do things that are good for me. I tried to do those cold showers for a while. Yeah. And yeah, people, a couple of people do them. I did stop though recently, I've got to say. Too cold was my main problem. Also, I was getting complaints from my neighbours that a young woman was screaming every morning. So. But I heard they are very good for you, and I heard one of the reasons they're really good for you is they say you start your day with something really hard, and then from there, the rest of the day is much easier. And to that I say, what if you just start your day normal and hope it's all right from there? Fingers crossed. Instead of torturing yourself every morning. Isn't starting the day hard enough as it is? I think it is. People love this. I can't get a wink of sleep lately because my weighted blanket has body dysmorphia. We're both tossing and turning, you know what I mean? It's crazy. Anyway, this next bit's sort of neither here nor there, but what the hell is going on with some of the bowling pins at the bowling alley? Has anyone seen this? Why has Jasmine got her cans out? I'm here with my son Philippe, trying to have a nice time. It's not appropriate for him. Although I gotta say, I can't take my eyes off her. She's really got something. No, she is my hall pass, and I hope to meet her one day. I don't know what I'd say to her, though. I'm a shy guy, one of these shy guys you hear about, and that's another thing I thought I'd grow out of, being shy, you know? Because you hear people be like, oh, he's a shy kid, you know? You never hear anyone be like, hey, he's a shy 40-year-old man, you know? That's what I'm going to be, shy 40-year-old man, going to parties with my girlfriend, hiding behind her dress, you know? That's the reaction I'm going for. I like laughs and pity in equal amounts. I'll be at a party, she'll be like, introduce yourself to people, Ben. I'll be like, I don't want to, you know? Just going up to the host of the party at the end of the night, just be like, my girlfriend said I should say thanks for having us. But no, I'm actually part of a shy men's meetup group. It's awesome, you know, we go to the park, mill around, look at the floor, and sort of, we've got bad posture and dandruff, and there's one guy there who had a hernia that he never had operated on, so he's like pressing in his hernia like that, and I know it's a very specific example. I only say it because I have seen a guy that does that, because I coach tennis, I coach kids tennis, I coach to this very popular path, everyone's walking up the path all the time. There's this guy I see that he's in his late 70s, every single time I see him, I swear to God, and I see him a lot, every single time I see him, sorry to be a bit sexual here, but he doesn't have his hand all the way down his pants, but it's like right here, like every single time. And so in my head, I'm like, maybe he had like a hernia once. I think that's where hernias are, and like he's pressing in the hernia, makes the hernia feel better. Anyway, either that or I'm giving a pedophile the benefit of the doubt, but hopefully it's not that. Anyway, enough fooling around. Now I've got to tell you what I'm going to put on my disc. So firstly, thank you. Firstly, I'm going to make a few changes to the original disc, a few things I thought they got wrong. So I'm going to say we're not all 160 centimetres. I'm going to say we all look like this guy. Jay Leno, we all look like Jay Leno. No, I'd like to be that big. That's my goal body. Imagine that. Wouldn't that be awesome? Imagine I'm that big, but I still do stand-up. That'd be great. I'm enormous, but I still do, like, silly jokes, you know? I'll try and help you picture it. So that's me. I'm up here. I'm like, I might get a little virgin daiquiri after the show. It's a normal daiquiri, but I drink it. Yeah. Get my pec stance, fly to a roid rage. That could be fun. But no, I'm into bodybuilding, I like it, and I watch some of these shows, and I don't know if you see it, but they put very dark fake tan on themselves for these shows. Very dark. Extremely dark. Really, really dark. What I'm trying to say, these guys aren't just getting away with blackface, they're getting away with black everything. It's crazy. Except for one guy I saw, he actually tried to do the opposite. He did black body, no blackface. Isn't that interesting? Somehow that's worse, I don't know why. I think that is horrific. I haven't seen something this scandalous since the Choco Vanilla Chupa Chup, alright? Disgraceful stuff. But no, I'm against anything bad, so I'll say it. you. Anything bad, I think it sucks. Racism, I hate it all. And because everyone's always talking about getting cancelled. I find it funny when people who aren't even in the public eye are worried about getting cancelled. You know, my uncle's always like that. He's like, Ben, they're going to come for me. They're coming for me. I'm going to get cancelled. I'm like, you work in a pet store. Why is anyone coming? What are you doing to those pets? But I feel like no one's thinking about the knock-on effect of some of these cancellations, you know? No one's thinking about some of the impersonators out there impersonating some of these celebrities who've been cancelled, you know? Michael Jackson, he's persona non grata. Always wanted to say that phrase. But there's a lot of Michael Jackson impersonators out there. Are they out of a job as well? You know, do they have to hang up the white glove? Can you separate the art from the artist from the person impersonating the artist? Yeah. I think you should be able to, you know. They're impersonating the singing and the dancing. They're not impersonating the other parts of his life. As long as they're not hanging out with the Macaulay Culkin impersonator during the day, I think it's fine. I mean, come on. Oh, good grief. Another thing that we should change on that original disc was that disgusting eating, drinking, licking photo. I think that was horrific. I think we all think that needs to change, so I've updated. So this is eating now. That's there, me having a bit of chocolate. And we got drinking, nice little chocolate smoothie there. And then we got licking. I swear I don't have worms, but I did have to buy the worms tablets for that bit. And, I gotta say, the lady who sold me the worms tablets said maybe the weirdest thing anyone's ever said to me. I was buying the worms tablets, and she goes, "Just want to let you know this is a very popular product right now." I'm not buying an Apple Watch, why are you saying that? Just want to let you know a lot of people have itchy assholes at the moment, and it might make you feel better. Another thing I think the aliens should think about, or we should tell them about, is if they come down here, they could be celebrities, you know? Celebrity, big thing on Earth, a lot of dangers, being celebrity, you know, paparazzi always out there trying to catch people at a bad moment, wardrobe malfunctions and the like. I actually saw quite a horrific wardrobe malfunction recently. It was on the red carpet of the movie The Lion, the Witch and the Wardrobe. I don't know if anyone saw it. It was quite horrible. Did anyone see this one? Doorknob slip. There's about four people really loving the show now, which is, that's all you can ask for. I like movies, I'm not afraid to say that. I like the movies, and that's another thing I've realised as I've gotten older. I like going to the movies alone. You know, and some people say I'm never alone because of the tapeworm, but I like you get to bring whatever snacks you want and no one will judge you. You know, I like to bring a minestrone soup and I bring it in a camelback and I slurp it up. But no, I actually like to match my snacks to the movie. I feel like most people, I'll just have a fun snack no matter what. I think that's deeply inappropriate. You're telling me you're going to have a chop top and a popcorn and a Coke watching Schindler's List? Outrageous. I match them up. I'm watching a depressing movie. I'm having a depressing snack. I'm watching The Boy in the Striped Pajamas. I'm having a crouton with a bit of herring on it. You know what I mean? I'm matching it up. But I remember when I first started going to the movies, you know, with my friends, 12, 13 years old, and I used to see a fella going to the movies by himself, and I used to think, oh, that's sad. That's sad. That guy's no one to go to the movies with. I remember thinking, I should really go sit next to that guy. I really thought that. I was a nice kid. I was like, I should keep him company. I think he'll appreciate it. But now I go to the movies alone, and I think back to that thought. I'm like, imagine if that happened to me now. What a fucking nightmare. I'm trying to enjoy the movie by myself. All of a sudden, some 13-year-old kid stands up, makes a beeline towards me. I'm like, what the fuck is going on right now? He sits down. I'm eating edible underwear out of a paper bag because I'm watching a rom-com. You know, I've matched it up. He sits down and is like, this is not an organised meetup, okay? We're not meeting up. Or I've got a hernia, that's why my hands are back. I'll be honest with you guys, I'm faffing around a bit up here. I don't really know what to put on this goddamn disc. Damn it! Oh, damn it! I've been taking a few acting classes. Shit, I think I'm getting a call. Oh my god, it's my acting agent. Sorry, I have to take this. Hello? What? Oh, crap. Oh, shit. Crap. Damn it. All right, thank you for letting me know. I didn't get the role. I was going for the role of guy who receives bad news over the phone. And my acting wasn't believable. I think I'd just tell the aliens, I would just say, look, you know, we're all doing our best down here on Earth, you know what I mean? Life is hard, you know, they say follow your dreams, but what if your dream is to hover above a dolphin's blowhole and use it like a bidet? And that's my dream, and, you know, I'm sure everyone here's had a hard life at different points, you know, I had a pretty hard upbringing, I've got to say. My dad was a degenerate gambler, he was, and his game of choice was strip poker. Thank you for laughing. He was addicted to strip poker. And he'd come home at night and be like, guys, I had a big win. You know, but we could tell he had it. The good thing was he never really beat us because he lost most of his belts. But anyway, I just say this little document I made tonight, I think I'm just going to send this document to the aliens, and I'm not going to send it by a golden disc. I'm going to do it the way we do things now, by a Wii transfer. So just going to send that now. Bing, 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 bing. Oh my God, I got a reply back. Holy crap. They downloaded it. You guys following the narrative? Oh my God, they sent a video back as well.
Hey Ben. Hey man. This is coming through alright. Internet's not great up here, it's still on 85G, so love the document. Thanks for sending it through. Didn't really need it though. Like pretty intelligent life forms up here, man. And not basic bitches. Like follow the Australian Comedy Festival circuit every year. Love the show. Loved it. Yeah, little request, at the start you mentioned that you're working on 127 hours of musical. One of our favourite movies, huh? Isn't it? It is. We love it, we love it. If you could just give us a little taste, oh man, that would be really something. Okay, alright, peace out, love you brother. Take care.
Wow. Did you guys see that? They want a taste of 127 hours of musical. Is that something any of you would be interested in? Yeah! Oh, okay, okay. Well, I guess to end the show, I'll give you a little taste for my musical next year. 127 hours of musical. All right. Oh, sorry, that's for it's my private collection. Here we go. Let's close out the show. Piss. I gotta drink my own fucking piss. Piss. I don't wanna, but I gotta drink piss. Piss. It's not really my cup of tea. Tea. I prefer a can on the pee. Pee. Hi, could I get some service? Piss. Piss. I like a big glass of my piss. Piss. Hey, you. And what about me? I've gotta drink a big glass of my pee. Carafe of my weed. Little snack from my Camelback. But it's not water. It's piss. I'm gonna drink my own piss. Imagine having to, you know, drink your own piss. But I have no other option. I have to drink my own piss to survive. Right. I love it. Piss, piss. Turns out I love drinking piss, piss. Glass half full or glass half empty. I don't care, I just want piss to plenty. I have a jellyfish thing, can you piss all over it? Where's the stick? It's in my mouth and gullet. It's warm, it's sterile, what's not to love? It's creamy, it's yellow, it feels like a glove. Drink drinking songs in the festival, so you guys are very... Thank you so much. You've been, I would say, and I'm not just saying, it's the best crowd I've had this whole time. I can't believe I have to do two more shows because they're going to suck compared to you guys. I've had some, you know, scary crowds the last few nights, but didn't even need the box tonight. But just got to bring it just in case. Thanks so much for coming, guys. I've got two shows left, so if you want to tell someone, you can, but you don't have to. I'm pretty chill like that. So thank you so much. Have a great night.